that it is based on our inability to focus on what is essential, but our legendary desire to always be preoccupied with trivialities, that Africa is what it is today. Mr. Speaker, if a visitor were to visit Nairobi and were to be informed that the Senate of the Republic of Kenya is meeting this afternoon, and they were given the question, why do you think the Senate of the Republic of Kenya is meeting? They would perhaps think that you are meeting as a reaction to the pleadings that were made by the Council of Governors Chair, Governor Wycliffe Oparanya, 3 days ago, reminding the country that up to this point as we speak, our county governments are yet to be furnished with funds to fight the COVID challenge that this country is facing. Or perhaps you would be told that this Senate is meeting to consider and try and establish the truth of the veracity of the claims that were made in the local dailies recently, that up to 358 billion of taxpayers' money that should have been used to fight this particular menace has been stashed away. Or even a simpler reason, Mr. Speaker, that we are just trying to brainstorm on how we can cushion our citizens during this difficult time. But lo and behold, Mr. Speaker, you will be told that you are meeting to discuss the conduct of a deputy speaker who failed to attend a meeting. Therefore, the Senate of the Republic of Kenya is gathered. Who cast us Africans, Mr. Speaker? What is our problem? Why do we ridicule the people that sent us to this house? If we had this same amount of energy and vigor that we are displaying this afternoon, then this house, Mr. Speaker, should have concluded the bill that was generated here more than a month ago on various responses to the challenges of COVID that are being faced by the various citizens that we represent in this house. But it is what it is, Mr. Speaker. That's why we are gathered. I want to speak to my friend, Professor Kithure Kindiki, and ask him to take heart and stay strong. Remember the words of the late Maya Angelou, the American poet, that don't make it your life mission to survive, but seek to thrive. Senator Kithure Kindiki, you have sought to thrive. Many will make the decision today that is convenient for them to survive politically, but you have chosen to thrive. I stand with you, my brother. Finally, in concluding, Mr. Speaker, I want to urge my colleagues, because you've had long lectures about political party loyalty, be loyal to the party leader. Read Article 91 of our Constitution before you sleep tonight, fellow senators, on what is a political party. I argue today before this House, Mr. Speaker, that a political party is not the party leader. When you disagree with the party leader, you have not disagreed with your party. And that is a mistake of Kithure Kindiki. Read, understand that a political party is about good governance. It's about the ideals of democracy. Go further and read Article 91 too, that in this country it is against the law to form a political party along the ideals of religion. I weep, Mr. Speaker, because what has befallen my party, Jubilee, is that it has become a religious cult. Why, if you disagree with the party leader, you are called a heathen and thrown out. That is what is happening to Kithure Kindiki, and it's against the law. We need to be sincere to ourselves and rise to the occasion as a house. Speak to the true ideals of democracy and say that enough is enough. If we believe that we are a house that is founded on truth, founded on all the ideals of democracy, you cannot support such a motion. Don't give us excuses and say, oh, political party loyalty. There is nowhere that shows that Kindiki has absconded his duties as a Jubilee senator. Senator Kindiki, walk proud and tall. I can assure you, because I know the pulse of the membership of Jubilee, the more than 8 million members of a Jubilee party, if a vote were to be taken today, they will stand with you and tell you that you're on the right path. Speak truth to power and stay true. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Senator Kinyua.